Hey everyone, it's Tim here, and in this video I'm going to give you four warm-ups that I use with my advanced students and that I also use myself for my practice. And you can stay tuned to the end and I'll let you know how you can get some actual sheets, some cheat sheets for reference for these warm-ups. So let's go. So warm-up number one, it's of course scales, because scales are great and everyone should do them. So when I'm practicing scales, I'll tend to work over four octaves with my advanced students. So we'll go up and down as usual, and then the grand scale form. I then like to do it in thirds as well, or actually like tenths to start with. And various combinations of that. You could do all of the same things in minor and melodic minor as well. Also, got to do some chromatic. So that's my kind of scale warm up, and that tends to be the thing that I do first. Secondly, I like to do what I call four finger warm ups, and I've got more information about these in another video. This works up chromatically, up the scale. You could also go down the scale, and it uses that same pattern that just repeats it over and over. And you can use fingers 2 to 5, or you can use fingers 1 to 4. So you can do the same thing. So that's my next one. So that's quite a close workout and a lot of sort of finger movement. What I then like to do is actually kind of spread out across the keyboard. So I use arpeggios, and I tend to use seventh arpeggios in this kind of a pattern. I've done that one in C major rather than D flat where I was working on my other scales. I tend to only use that pattern starting on white notes. You can use it with a major triad at the bottom, a minor triad, diminished, or even augmented. So there's lots of possibilities through that. So the fourth one is for octaves. So I tend to go around the circle starting in C, moving between major and minor. Minor form. Etc. So they're my top four warm-ups that I use myself and I encourage my advanced students to use. Now, that last exercise, by the way, can of course be quite stressful, so I don't work around the whole cycle. I'll just do a few of the movements one day, so I might work between, I don't know, C major and down to E flat minor or something like that, and then I'll do the other half in a subsequent practice session. So of course, if there's any pain with any of these exercises or uncomfortability, then this might not be the right thing to do, and certainly if you're not used to any of these, don't jump right into them. But that's my four go-to advanced warm-ups for pianists who are at the advanced levels. If you'd like to know anything more, let me know. And if you'd like to find out more about some of the patterns that I've used and watch in more detail and grab a download, then check out the description below for more details. I would love to hear, what are your favorite warm-ups? Everyone does it differently, so what do you like to do? Leave a comment below, I'd love to know. And of course, as always, please hit the subscribe button so you are notified when we next release a video. Speak to you soon.